Hi all, welcome to clickshare.com. I wanted to thank you for visiting my blog. A few days back, one of the community member, Geeta, she asked me a question about how to set up a URL on a straight table. I thought it should be pretty straightforward. However, she wanted to set up the URL on the dimension itself and not on the expression. And this request made me think, and I figured out that we don't have representation property on the chart dimensions. So I've decided to play with the chart properties to see if this can be achieved. Finally, I've got it working, and I don't recommend this as a 100% clean solution, but you can still use this chart if you have an absolute requirement of using the URL as dimension. So let's get started. So before I go ahead and proceed further, I wanted to show you how you can set up URL as an expression. I'm sure most of you are aware, but I thought it would be easy for someone who is not aware. So let me quickly load some data. Control R, and I've loaded some data. So I have some sample data about 20 companies and their sales details. So I'll quickly add the chart object here. And let me click on, let's select straight table and click on next. My dimension is company ID. Click on next. Move this window. And my measure is sum of sales. Okay. And click on finish. So we have information here, and we have company number and the sales. And we wanted to show the URL. So let's add under expressions tab, click on add, and then we'll use the URL tag and type in the URL. So I'll probably type my blog's URL, and this should be within quotes, and let's say probably I would use the company ID as the reference. Click on OK. And representation, you have to change the representation to link. And I'll call this as that address. Click on apply and click on OK. So now you see company one. If I click on it, this should actually show my blog. So yeah, let me grab the window and let me adjust it. So there we go. So the link is a reference to my blog, and you can see the information by clicking on the link itself. So let me close this. So you can click on any of the company IDs, but of course right now, just for demonstration purpose, we have the constant link, but your link can be actually referenced from a field where the field contains each company has their own web address, so it can be their web address. So that's definitely possible. However, in our situation, now we wanted the web address or the actual URL itself to be on the dimension. So we wanted the URL as the dimension instead of an expression. So right now this is an expression, but we wanted the URL as dimension so that people can click on it. So right now if I click on company 6, it's filtering the data. That's the natural click view behavior. However, you wanted to have this as a URL, then we need to go through some configuration process. So I'll show you how to do that. So let me just clear the selection, and the steps are very similar until you create the text as the URL. However, what I'll do here is I'll move the web address onto the left. So again, I'll show you how to move it. As soon as you click on the header and then you move it on the right, you see the blue line mark. So you can move it across onto left to right and right to left. So I moved it onto the extreme left hand side. Now let me go back to properties, and then let me call this company ID and click on apply. And let me say this, don't want any totals. And no totals for this SL. So we don't want any totals at all. And click on dimensions. So here we see this information, but we don't want to see company number one twice. We just wanted to see it once, so we have to hide it some way so that we will not see this information. So you have an option here under properties, and if you go under styles, under presentations, you have your dimension and you can hide your dimension, so your dimension can be hidden. I'll say hidden column, click on apply and click on OK. So now if you see, if I click on company 4, it will actually redirect to my blog. So this works as a link, but it will not allow you to make any selections. So that's pretty cool. However, let's say that you wanted to make some selections, but at the moment you can't make the selections because the dimension is hidden. So we wanted to show the dimension. So we wanted to hide the dimension, but we still wanted to make the selections. So to get this working, let's go back to properties again. And as soon as we say hide a dimension, we will not be able to make any selections. So let's click on show column. Let's keep it as show column. And I'll change few things here. And then let's go back to dimensions and click on the plus sign here and click on the text color. And I'll say white and I'll keep the alpha value as 0. And click on OK. Okay. So now if you see, you will see the text in white color and the opacity or the alpha value itself is set to 0. What this means is if I change the background color to probably black, click on OK. So you will still not see the text because the alpha value is set to 0. So let me go back and change this. We don't want any color in the background. Apply. And let's minimize this. Okay, so now we have the column itself, and if I click on OK, so we can make selections here. It works fine, but it still looks clunky. It doesn't look good. It doesn't look good to have an empty field. So let me clear the selection. So let me just go back to properties again. And to take this a step further, I would recommend you to use the style tab, and we can actually remove the lines, the border lines. So I'll say that remove the border line, remove cell border. Yeah, we have this. And okay, once we have this, now I don't want this name to be appearing twice. So I'll go back to dimensions and click on the label and then just give an empty space. So now you see that there is nothing there, as if you're just looking at two columns. It's ideally three columns, just because we have taken the vertical border lines. It seems like as we are having just two columns. Now let's go back and change a few more things. We don't want the sorting here. So let's go back to presentation tab. And let's uncheck this. So the sorting is disappeared. Okay, now let's click on OK. And then let me move this onto the left hand side. And adjust this as well. Okay, so now if you click here, it opens up the URL. And let's say that if I wanted to make selections, I click here and I can see that I can make selections. And I can also click here, I can see that I can make the selections. So it's a simple technique, and like I said, it's not a straightforward way of doing things. But sometimes you have to push the limits to get something working. And this clearly shows that ClickView is a very flexible BI tool. And I personally like to push the limits of doing something like this. And if thoroughly enjoyed making this video, I hope you have enjoyed too. Thank you once again for watching. Have a good day.